بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على من كان نبيا وآدم بين الماء والطين. أما بعد، فقد قال رسول الله صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم: إني لأستغفر الله في اليوم 100 مرة، أو كما قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. Respected viewers, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakat. Inshallah ta'ala, I would like to commence this evening's Dars-e-Hadith program with a story from the wonderful and inspirational figure of Sayyiduna Imam al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala, who was the grandson of our master, of our beloved Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who in his blessed words, Sayyiduna Imam al-Hasan is the leader of the youth of paradise. Our messenger alayhi salatu wassalam said, Al-Hassan wal-Husayn Sayyida Shabab Ahlil Jannah. Sayyiduna Imam Husayn radiallahu ta'ala anhum was a wonderful, inspirational figure of Islam, a true abid, a worshipper of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We are told in Tariq al-Khulafa, written by Imam Jalaluddin Suyuti rahmatullahi alayhi, that during his lifetime, Sayyiduna Imam al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala performed 25 hajjs during his lifetime. And for each one of them, he walked towards the Haram Sharif in Makkah. Subhanallah. So he was a great worshipper, a great abid, and a great rememberer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the same time, and this is where our story this evening comes in, he was a person that was approached all of the time by the Muslims for advice, for nasiha, for their spiritual, for their physical needs. And so that is what this story, inshallah ta'ala, is about. On one occasion, and in fact it was in one sitting, many people came to Sayyiduna Imam al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala anhu for advice. And one man appeared in front of the grandson of the messenger alayhi salatu wasalam and said, Ya Imam al-Hasan, I want some advice and nasiha, for we live in a land which has become barren, in which there is no rainfall whatsoever. Sayyiduna Imam al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala simply informed him and advised him to do istighfar as much as possible. Recite Astaghfirullah Rabbi min kulli zambin wa atubu ilayk. The man disappeared. A few moments later, another man disappeared, and he had his own situation, and he described it to the grandson of the messenger alayhi salatu wasalam and said that, Ya Imam al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala, we are suffering from poverty. We have no money. So please give us something by which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can overturn our situation. Imam al-Hasan gave him exactly the same advice and said, Istaghfirullah. Seek forgiveness and in abundance recite Astaghfirullah. A third person appeared in the presence of this great Imam, and he said to him that, Oh Imam, that please pray for me, or please give me a wazifa or a wird that I can perform, for we have no children. Subhanallah, Imam al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala, he gave him the exact same advice as well. He said, Astaghfirullah is what you need to recite if you want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you children. A fourth individual appeared, and he had a completely different story to tell to Imam al-Hasan, and he said that, Ya Imam Hassan, please pray or please give us a wazifa or give me something to recite, for our agriculture is suffering. That there is a problems with our farming and with our fields, and there is no rizq coming from it. That our gardens have become totally dry. Allahu Akbar. This man, he was given the same advice that Imam al-Hasan gave to all of the others. That in abundance recite Astaghfirullah. Whilst this was going on and all of this happened in one single majlis, in one simple gathering, eventually the people who were sitting around Imam al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala, they said that, Ya Imam al-Hasan, we trust what you have said. But people came with very, very different needs and requirements. Someone was asking you for rain, someone was asking for money, someone was asking for children, some was asking for their agricultural needs. And for each and every one of these people, you gave exactly the same piece of advice. Imam al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala anhu replied, that ma kultu min indi shay'a, that you have just seen I have given the same advice to all of these people. This has not stemmed from myself. This is not something that I have come out with. All I am doing, Imam al-Hasan explained, is I am advising them of the beautiful set of verses that Allah has revealed in Surah Nuh, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَقُلْتُ اسْتَغْفِرُوا رَبَّكُمْ إِنَّهُ كَانَ غَفَّارًا, that seek forgiveness from your Lord, for He is the one who forgives the most. يُرْسِلِ السَّمَاءَ عَلَيْكُمْ مِدْرَارًا, and when you do istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send down rain in abundance. وَيُمْدِدْكُمْ بِأَمْوَالٍ, and not just that, Allah will help you with money, with rizq. وَبَنِينَ, and He will grant you children. وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ جَنَّاتٍ وَيَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ أَنْهَارًا, and not only that, just by this one wazifa, this one dua that you were performing, astaghfirullah, Allah will also grant you gardens, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant you streams as well. Allahu Akbar. So all in effect Imam al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala was doing, that he was doing the tafsir of this wonderful set of verses of Surah Nuh, in which we are told of the multiple benefits of reciting Astaghfirullah Rabbi min kulli zambi wa atubu ilayh, that I seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from my sins and I turn to Him. And this is just one example from Surah Nuh. Elsewhere in the Holy Quran we are told of different fawaid and benefits to be derived when a person recites Astaghfirullah abundantly. In another place in the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that when you do istighfar, what will be the outcome of it? وَيَزِدْكُمْ قُوَّةً عِلَىٰ قُوَّتِكُمْ, Allah will give you strength upon strength. You become physically and mentally and spiritually the most strongest people in the community. Elsewhere in Surah Hud, Allah says that if you seek forgiveness from Allah in abundance, what will He do? يُمَتَّئْكُمْ مَتَاءً حَسَنًا, Allah will give you a wonderful life. He is talking about the dunya here. Allah will give you enjoyment. Allah will give you happiness and ecstasy in all means of your life. And subhanAllah, this is all stemming from one simple wird that Allah has given to you and I. One single wazifa, one single dua that you should be performing. And therefore there is no surprise that Rahmatan lil Alameen sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, he asked his ummatis, he asked you and I, that however you can, whenever you can, recite these wonderful words of Astaghfirullah Rabbi min kulli zambin wa atubu ilayh. Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that man lazim al istighfar, جَعَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ مِنْ دَيْكٍ مَخْرَجًا وَمِنْ كُلِّ هَمٍ فَرْجًا وَرَزَقَهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ, that whosoever regularly, and we are not just talking about a one-off, but who makes it a daily habit of his, if he recites istighfar often, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him an exit from every single tight spot that he finds himself. He will give him relief from any type of anxiety that he comes across. And in addition to all of these things, وَرَزَقَهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give him rizq like he could never imagine. And that is again why our messenger sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, in order for you and I to do it, he informed us that he who never made a mistake in his life, who never committed a sin, whether it is a major sin or whether it is a minor sin, whether it is before the public announcement of Nabuwa, whether it is after, Sayyidina Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never made a mistake in his entire life. Yet in his blessed words, he says that I recite Astaghfirullah 100 times a day, that I am constantly seeking forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if he, that great individual, that wonderful being who never made a mistake in his life, if he was reciting it 100 times a day throughout his life, then what lesson is that for you and I? People, unfortunately, who are totally engrossed in sins, who are committing sins left, right and centre, who are committing sins day by night, certainly it is encouragement for you and I to recite istighfar in abundance, to conclude one important wazifa that we have been given, so that it becomes a habit of ours as soon as possible, so that at least we are reciting it with regularity. We have been told and encouraged that after every single fard prayer that we perform, the Fajr, the Zuhr, the Asr, the Maghrib and Isha, at least 3 times after reciting Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah and concluding our salah, we should immediately recite Astaghfirullah 3 times. When we do this, like the story of Sayyidina Al-Hasan radiallahu ta'ala anhu shows, like the wonderful verses from the Holy Quran show, like the guidance of our Messenger alayhi salatu wa salam certainly proved, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will engulf us all in His rahmah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us rizq like we can never imagine, and certainly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive our sins in these difficult, in these unprecedented, in these sensitive times. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us all the ability to repent to Him. Ameen. Wa ma alayna illa al-balaghul mubeen.